interviewed Don Freshy from Sport Fishing on the Fly. Also got to meet Phil Rowley, which was kind of cool. Got him to sign one of my books, which is kind of neat. I also picked up this beauty right here, Fly Patterns of BC from Art Lindgren. It's got some cool old school stuff, and I'm going to be tying my way through this one in the next little bit. So today you're going to get one of those patterns. Yesterday myself and my buddy Jordan, who we had on the show last week, went out steelheading up in Squamish. Your average typical steelhead day, lots of snow, no fish. It was a good day to practice our casting, which was kind of fun. But as I was sitting there, we're fishing one run, and I noticed that all my flies were weighted. Kind of all those new school patterns use the dumbbell eyes and stuff like that. So I figured, time to type some old school stuff that's not weighted. So I'm going to do this one here. It is called Tolley's Puller Shrimp. It was developed by Martin Tolley. He came over from England in the 1950s, made his way out west down to Vancouver, and he loved fishing the Squamish River. So he came up with this pattern kind of in the 60s. It's kind of a cool fly. So I'm definitely going to fill my box with a few of them, definitely take them to the river next time I'm out. So let's head on down and check this one out. Alright everybody, so there it is, Tolley's Puller Shrimp. I'll give you a little rotation there. It's a pretty sexy looking fly. So some of the materials that he did on his original dressing I do not have. So I'm doing my best to make do with what I've got. This is tied, or he has it here listed as a number, as a size 2 to a 1-0. Myself here today, I've got a Mustad 36890 size 2, and I think it's a pretty cool looking fly. It's kind of similar to that spruce fly that me and Boulder did last week. Just kind of in the way the wing sits and stuff like that. A little bit different though. So let's pop that out of the vise. So like I said, this one was developed for the Squamish waters. That's where I love fishing. Beautiful area up there. We were fishing all day yesterday. Couldn't find nothing. So we had a lot of fun though. Well, even though it's snowing. So I'm just gonna start my thread here. I've got some, what is this? Some 210 Danville in black. I like this because it lays flat. This is a return eye hook, so I'm gonna start up close to the eye. Cinch all that down. Trim that away. Kind of bring that back up. Really lock in that eye. Nice and good. So this is very similar to the UTC thread. You give it a counterclockwise spin, it lays flat for you. So we're going to take our thread all the way back, pretty much to in line with the hook point there. So the first material I'm going to tie in here is going to be my tail, and it's just going to be a normal orange saddle hackle. I got one kind of started here. So I'm just going to take a clump of fibers off of one side, kind of stack them all together, and I'm going to measure that off the back, pretty much the length of the fibers there. So I'll just tie that in by the butts, get that locked in. Alright, we'll take our thread up. Go back to about the halfway point here. We're going to tie in some gold silver uni mylar number 12 I've got here. You can go a little bit larger if you like. It's all up to you. They all do the same thing. Just a few more wraps needed for this one. I'm just going to trim that off the spool. And I'm going to tie this so it's gold on one side, silver on the other. And I'm going to tie it the gold side down. That's the side that I want to be showing. So the silver side's facing me right now. Just a couple loose wraps. I'm going to pull that to length. And touching turns, creating a nice smooth body here. Tie that right back to the tail. And give this a little counterclockwise spin. That flattens the thread out. We'll follow that back up. Just create a nice smooth underbody. Just a little past that halfway point. Just gonna take a little bit of glue. There's no rib on this fly, so we want something to kind of protect the tinsel. Just a little dab of glue here. That should do the trick. So now I'm going to start wrapping. As I said, I tied the gold side down. And as I wrap, that gold side is the side that's showing. You just slightly overwrap the turns, or overlap, I should say. If you don't like it, go back and kind of keep some nice tight tension on there. Like I said, this is a pretty cool, old school kind of pattern. Brad was saying it needs more UV, and the hackle I put on the front definitely has some UV properties to it. Show that to you guys under the light when we're done here. So just capture that in at the halfway point. Just a couple turns there, just to lock it down. Trim that tinsel, kind of wind that forward. Now what we're going to do, we're going to dub the second half of the body here. So, what I've got, Superfly Diamond Dub in fluorescent orange. And I've got the imitation seal dubbing box here with the yellow. So I'm going to actually blend those two together. So I take about half and half. The diamond dub makes it a little bit easier to dub on. So a little bit of the diamond, a little bit of the yellow. Kind of stack them together. Then you just pull them apart, kind of work them together, blend them up. That's a little different dimension to this fly. And we're going to create fairly loose dubbing noodle here. And we're just going to start to wrap. So we want this to be fairly bushy. It doesn't have to be super tight. This is all kind of a tricky material to work with. You could use some dubbing wax if you wanted. This is not dubbing how I want it, so I'm just going to peel that off. Start again. See if we can kind of capture that in. There we go. Just capture it. Light twist. There we go. Nice and loose. Build a fairly bulky body here. Keep twisting that on. So some dubbing wax would probably help with this. We'll go a little bit heavier with the diamond dub. That stuff seems to grab kind of like Velcro. And we're making this fairly bushy. There we go. Now she's cooperating. And just kind of pull that back a little bit. I don't want it to extend too far out back there. I kind of want that gold to be there as well. So you can kind of just trim that away if you like. A few stragglers is okay. Alright, so now we're going to add our underwing. And what I've got here is just some Superfly fox tail. And I've taken a very sparse clump here. Like, not much at all. I actually took one clump and halved it to get the right length there. Or the right sparseness, I should say. So that I'm going to measure a little bit past the tail. We're going to tie that directly on top. I did this with bucktail as well. I find the original pattern called for polar bear. I do not have any, so this is probably going to be my closest material too. It does kind of go a little bit translucent in the water. And as well, the underbody on the original called for orange polar bear, just the under fur. So I'm just going to lock that in right on top. That's not going to go anywhere. And now I'm going to add my second wing. So I like to use the bottom portion of the hackles here for the collar, like right here. And then what I like to do is keep the tips. So I've already tied up a couple, so I've got an extra tip here. And all we're going to do is just measure that up, just one strand. We're not going to go two. We're going to measure that almost the same length as that foxtail. Maybe a smidge longer, like so. So what we're going to do is just pull off the rest of those fibers from the stem. We're going to take a few extras off the bottom, just so that helps to lay it how we want. Hey, how's it going? So I'm just gonna tie that right in on top, like so. Just a few wraps there. That's going to be, get it kind of sitting how I want, make sure everything's all right. So you can see everything's just kind of stacked on top. When you're done the fly, you can kind of part some of that fox on either side. I'm going to take that extra stem, double it over. That guy's not going anywhere. Trim off that stem there. Now I'm going to take another one of these hackles. I'm going to get rid of all this junk off the bottom. Save that for dubbing if you like. Again, I'm going to tie this on the side. Got the nice side facing me. I'm going to leave a little bit of extra stem there just to help secure that in some of the wraps. Wind that on there. Double that stem over again. Really lock it down. I'm going to trim away that stem. Now, I'm just going to preen those fibers back. Give them a little pinch. That just helps to get them seated how you want. We're going to force that on. So depending on the feathers, how many wraps you're going to get. Some I've had are quite sparse, and I've only gotten about maybe 6 or 7 wraps. Some of these fuller ones, like this one, I'm going to get 3 to 5. So there's wrap number 3, just one in front of the other. No, I'm going to go one more. Here's number 4. Just take my thread back. Capture that stem. I'm going to give it a 90 degree bend. That just allows me to get some more securing wraps there. As you can see, by bending that feather, allows me to lock it in place a little bit better. And I'm just going to stroke everything back. I'm going to wrap back on that hackle. I'm going to create a nice clean head here. It's a pretty simple fly. You know, it's deadly looking color combo though, so I'm just going to clean that up a little bit more. I think it's going to do quite well the next time I'm out on the Squamish. So now I've got a whip finisher. Just going to whip finish this fly. Going to tidy up that head a little bit. Really lock that down in place. Trim away that extra hackle. Nice and close. There we go, that's pretty much it. Now we're just gonna coat the head here. So I've got some UV clear fly finish and flow. Works the same as any kind of varnish that you could use. This one just dries a little bit quicker. As soon as you set it with that UV light, it's done. So the flow is really gonna seep into those thread wraps, create a nice shiny head. Dries tack free, which is nice. Just kinda give that a couple spins. As you can see, that front hackle, which I mentioned, it's a fluorescent orange hackle on the front there. So different from the tail feathers, which is just normal orange. And that should be pretty much cured. So as you can see, that underbody, hopefully you can see that there, really shines with UV light. So there you have it, Tolley's polar shrimp. Pretty killer little pattern, easy to tie. So let's head on back up and sign out. Alright guys, so there you have it, Tolley's polar shrimp, pretty killer little pattern, like I said. Really looking forward to fishing this one, giving it a go, as well as tying through that book. Check us out on Facebook, give us some suggestions for flies that you'd like to see. If not, we're just going to keep on doing what we do, which is tying up some cool stuff for you guys. A lot of forgotten patterns in this book, I'm sure, so let's bring those ones back to life. You can hit us up with email questions as well. That's pros, P-R-O-S, at fridaynightflies.com. We'll get back to you as soon as we can. Any questions, you want to share some flies with us, anything like that, please just hit us up and we'll get back to you as best as we can. So, hope you guys enjoyed. We're going to have, I think Jordan's coming in, if he hasn't already run his show already. He's going to be tying up something for you guys, and hope you guys enjoy the rest of the show, and we'll see you next week.